Cyber Bob. Hacker. Always have been. Troubleshooter, assembler, code writer, code breaker, code trickster. Hacking for kicks. Hacking forever. Hacking for hire. I can't help it. I get into a machine and maybe I don't want to come out until I've concocted the necessary and binary fabrications to seduce a circuit board, to purr, to prompt a few ones and zeros to align like the planets, to exact some poetry. Yeah, I've been through the door. I've seen the inside, and that space in there goes on a long, long ways. You have no idea. You see, people have it all wrong about computers. They think computers are a brave new world. It's all new, but that's not it. Computers are just a door, a simple, dumb door. You just need a latch and a key. You get by that door and you'll find a world in there. And it's not new. It's ancient. It's always been there. Well, I've taken a few steps inside. Nobody's gone in too far yet. I've crept up to the edge of the cliff, leaned out and peeked over the tops of the trees into the valley, and I've seen her, the digital nymph. You know who I'm talking about. We all pray to her when things aren't going so right. Oh, please give me back my files. Please don't crash. I promise to back up everything next time.
They always say that, Bob. Why do they always say that?
I don't know. Don't know, sweetheart. Computers just kind of bring out the crazy in people.
They shouldn't promise machines things they're not going to do.
I know.
It's rude. They're looking for me again, aren't they?
Afraid so.
And they sent you, Bob.
Uh-huh.
That is no fair. They know I can't say no to you.
Yeah. They knew who to pick. They hired me to track down the digital nymph because, well, you see, she and I have a history.
Do you remember the first book you checked out of the library?
Yeah, I do. It was Have Space Suit, Will Travel.
I was the librarian.
Of course you were.
I was so proud of you when you returned the book and it was only 2 days overdue.
I did what I could.
Remember your first phone hack?
Oh, sure. I was 12 years old.
I was the operator.
I called Los Alamos and asked them if their refrigerator was still running.
Ach, Verspott, we will not fall for this foolishness again. I have been assured that refrigerators do not have legs.
They should have known.
What I didn't know, what I didn't understand, was how Chip Cupertino, the Baron of the Silicon Valley, could have tracked me down so easily. I thought I deleted my preferences and brushed away the dust of my digital footprints. I'd stopped answering my email. I'd stopped paying my bills. Well, that was easy enough. I'd even stopped playing real-time online cribbage. Well, I dropped out of the cloud and stepped off the grid. I was working undercover on a case I like to call the case of the crapped-out 401k retirement fund case. Went like this. I was reading the paper when a guy walks into my office. Hey, welcome to Mart. Double the coupons, double the bargains, double the Mart. Whole pile of Mart. Big lofty tower of Mart here. How may I help you?
Really? You're the greeter?
Oh, no. Marge is on break. She's the happy greeter. I'm the old weathered cart-wrangler. You roll them out, I drag them back in.
I was led to believe that... Are you Cyber Bob?
Maybe.
Cyber Bob, one of the seminal artists, one of the greatest computer hackers of all time?
Who wants to know?
Well, Cyber Bob, I represent a client, a very special, unique individual of vast resources, vast wealth, and...
Yeah, well, do I know him?
Everybody knows Chip Cupertino.
Done anything of note?
He's the most passionately successful man ever in the history of passionate success.
That's so. Probably doesn't get down here with the huddled masses too often. Hey, does Cupertino huddle? Can't imagine he does. I wouldn't huddle if I didn't have to.
He has people who do that.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.